Hello everyone, my name is Abhay Shahi and I'm currently working with IndoVision Services Private Limited in HR department. In today's video, we will talk about the recent changes in income tax for salaried person. From the current financial year 2020-21, a new tax regime has been introduced in the budget 2020 with reduced tax slabs under the new section 115 BSE. You have an option to choose between the old and the new tax regime as per your preference and intimate the selection to your employer. If such intimation is not made by you, the employer shall consider it as old tax regime and deduct your tax accordingly. Once you make your selection, you cannot switch to the other scheme during the rest of the financial year. You can only switch to the other scheme at the time of income tax return filing. In case you want to opt for new tax regime, you will have to forego certain tax exemption and deduction. In most cases, with the new tax regime, foregoing tax deduction and exemption, income tax work out to be higher. Let's compare the two tax regime and know which one is better for you. There are two differences between the old and new tax regime. One, in the new tax regime, tax slab have reduced tax rates compared to the old regime. Two, all the exemption and deduction that you can claim in the old tax regime won't be available for you in the new tax regime, like standard deduction, ATC, ATD, housing allowance, etc. Under the new tax regime, income between 5 lakh to 7.5 lakh would be taxed at 10%, while income between 7.5 lakh to 10 lakh would be taxed at 15%. This was 20% flat on the entire range in the old tax regime. Earlier, 10 lakh plus slab where you paid 30% has been broken into 3 parts with rates of 20% for 10 lakh to 12.5 lakh, 25% for 12.5 lakh to 15 lakh and then 30% for 15 lakh and above. The first reaction would be that the new tax regime looks better. However, with the new tax regime, you will have to forego certain exemption and deduction which might nullify these gains. As you can see, below is list of exemption and deductions which are allowed or not allowed. Let's take some example with different scenarios to see how deduction and exemption will impact your taxes in both regimes.
In the first example, assume a person's gross salary is 50,000 per month. Its annual salary comes to 6 lakh. Standard deduction of 50,000 is available to every salaried person in the old tax regime. Suppose he doesn't have any other investment to claim. Net taxable income in the old tax scheme comes to 5,50,000 and 6 lakh in the new tax regime, as 50,000 standard deduction is not available in the new tax regime. Let's see the tax calculation. Up to 2,50,000, it is nil in both old and new. From 2,50,000 to 5 lakh, it is 5% in both the cases, that comes to 12,500. From 5 lakh to 7.5 lakh, it is 20% in old slab and 10% in new slab. So 20% of 50,000 is 10,000. And 10% of 1 lakh is 10,000. So as you can see, the total tax in both the scheme is same, 23,400, and there is no saving whether you choose old or new tax scheme.
But old tax scheme would be a better option here, as you can minimize your tax liability by investment. But in case of new tax scheme, you can't save tax. Suppose you invest 1,000 per month in PPF. By investing only 12,000, you can save tax up to 2,500 in old tax scheme. And if you invest 50,000, you can save the whole 23,400 as repeat under 87A of 12,500 would be available, as net taxable income will be 5 lakh. Let's take a next example of a person who's earning 75,000 per month. His annual gross salary comes to 9 lakh. First, suppose he's not investing anything. In this scenario, the tax under old is 85,800, while due to the reduced tax slab under new tax scheme, it is 62,400. A tax saving of 23,400 is there if you select new tax scheme. Now we will find out how much we should invest to nullify the gains under the new tax regime. You should invest 1,12,500 to reduce the tax saving to zero. That means if you have investment of less than 1,12,500, you should choose the new tax regime as it will benefit you. But if you are someone who's already investing more than this, you should stick to old tax regime. Suppose you are currently getting XRA exemption of 60,000 and you have invested 50,000 in ATC via PF, LIC, tuition fee, etc. And you have a mediclaim of 7,500. As you can see, by making these three basic investment, you can save tax up to 1,040 rupees. So basically, it depends on you whether you have investment or not. Let's take the next example of a person who's earning 1 lakh per month. His annual gross salary comes to 12 lakh. First, assume he's not making any investment. In this scenario, under the old scheme, his tax would be 1,63,800, while in new it will be 1,19,600. Tax saving would be 44,200 if you select the new tax scheme. But if you are earning 1 lakh per month, you must have some investment. Suppose you have taken a home loan in which you are paying interest of 1 lakh. Similarly, when you pay interest in home loan, the principal amount you will get the principal amount exemption in ATC. Suppose it is 75,000. You will save tax of 7,800 in old tax scheme if you have this investment. Apart from this, if you have additional investment, suppose you are paying 15,000 mediclaim for yourself and your family, you will further increase the tax saving to 10,920 rupees. So you should stick to old tax scheme if you have investment, and if you have no investment, then you should definitely shift to new tax regime as it will benefit you.
By this example, we can say that new tax regime is better for individuals who have no investment and are not planning to make the same anytime sooner. You should stick to old tax regime if you have home loan or have a significant amount of investment. I have given the link of income tax calculator for comparing old and new tax regime in the description. You can download it and fill up the details to know which tax regime works better for you. I hope this income tax calculator will be useful to you. Do share your feedback in the comment section and don't forget to like, share and subscribe to this channel. Thank you.